雷猴，我是怪喽。这个都是 HKDSE 香港的指考，我们今天要一起考这个。What's up, guys? Welcome to 咪讲美语。I'm Logan， 我们一起上课吧。A while back, I took the Taiwan 指考 the English College Entrance Exam, and I got a 100 perfect score. 十全十美。你看得到吗？The Hong Kong Diploma of Secondary Education. Similar to what the Taiwan 指考 was, I heard it's a bit different and it's a lot harder. Let's jump in it together. Okay, guys, before we actually jump into the test and try it out, I want to go over exactly what this test really is. Now, this year I'm going to be taking the 2017 DSE English test. I've actually got test A. They've got multiple different tests that split up the different answers. Make sure no one's cheating. This test actually focuses on a few things. Reading, writing, listening and integrated skills, and communication skills. This happens to be it. It comes in two little sections. Now, first of all, this is the 2017 DSE. That's the one that I could find online that has the answers to be able to let me grade it. It's a very secretive test. You've actually got your answer book right here, and then you've got your reading passages. So this test actually isn't really going to be fair because this is for ESL, the English Second Learners. I'm going to go in to read this. I'll check in with you guys in just a moment. The myth of recycling. If you live in the United States, the United States, the test is about the United States. The test is about me. Okay.
有点无聊。
Hey Logan. 别太舒服吧。
为什么？
因为你只有一个小时
半。一个小时半 ？I do all of that. Hey, let's go.Now that's the difficult part. You only have an hour and a half to read that. That was just one segment. So this is part one. Let's get the questions going. Now right here, actually, according to paragraph one, what benefits are supposedly gained from recycling? So what's neat is here, these questions aren't fill in the blank. It's not like I can just go and say, okay, this. I still have to write it in a complete sentence and really stretch my English vocabulary and understanding.
我很久没有上课，你知道吗？很久没有上课，什么东西？还有我自己讨厌考试，我讨厌考试。
But anyways, let's go. OK, 每个考试有几个部分，我有选择做比较辛苦、比较难的 test。这个我先做 A, which is compulsory. Now I'm doing B2, which is difficult section. If I were to choose B1, that's more of an easier test. But 我要一个挑战 ，so I 选了。B2, the difficult test. So, 我们要开始做这个，还有很多 reading. Oh my gosh! Millennial. Test is on millennial. 你知道 millennial 吗
？Manuel.
This is the millennial challenge. Here we go.
我要说试很快。
Millennial. I did it, guys. This is my test. I took my cover paper off because I didn't want it. And I'm done. I filled it out. Look how much writing. I'm just going to skim through this and you guys can see how much writing is in this. Are you ready? Dun 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 So I am definitely going to have some wrist cramps tomorrow. I'm going to need a brace.Because this thing is tiring, but real quick, let's grade it, and then I'll talk to you guys a little bit about my thoughts on this test, what I think is good, what I think is wrong, and how you and millennials, and how you guys can improve from this and learn to take it better. Did I get a perfect score? Not really. It's because inside this test, you have to write sentences, paragraphs, and based on how you wrote them, if you had the answer or not, you could still get docked points due to maybe your sentence structure or how well it fit or punctuation or something like that. So in reality, I would probably get around a 95, as well as I didn't have the oral test. But otherwise, guys, This was a good test. Now let me talk to you a little bit about it. I thought the contents inside the test were actually really good. The very first part of A, which is the compulsory section, that had a whole big reading segment about recycling, something that we could all learn from. Inside, it was actually not too hard of English, but it was ones that definitely stretched your mind and would actually take someone who studied the language for quite some time to understand the article and the content that was inside. B2, it then talked about millennials. Once again, something more relative to today, something people should know, words that people should know. And overall, once again, you had to really stretch your mind with how well you wrote the sentences, with the paragraphs and the answers. I thought this test was amazing. I thought it was really good. 如果英文不是你的母语，这个考试肯定会很难。所以如果你可以考90分、80分，我还是觉得你蛮厉害。 My Hong Kong friends, what do you think about this test? What year did you take? What did you get? Put it in the comments down below. Otherwise, guys, I have a fun fact to tell you. Once again, sometimes speaking stuff, I don't have the most eloquent English. I love to speak slang. I love to speak more down-to-earth English. But I do actually have a rich understanding of it. There's a test, it's called ACT, much like the SAT. My overall score wasn't too high, but I got a 29 on the English. Is this something to brag about? Not crazy to brag, but it's definitely up there. So I love taking these tests, I love stretching my English, and being able to tell you guys what I think about it, what you guys need to know. 我们觉得我下一个国家是考该考哪一个? Otherwise, guys, thought this was awesome. Make sure you put all your comments down below. I love you guys so much. Make sure you hit like. Make sure you subscribe. Do what you gotta do. And I think you guys all know what to say. 喝一杯，快乐一杯，丽江万岁。